In light of the tragic accident that has put the whole nation in despair, the Education Ministry has stepped in to prevent further accidents. And for details, we now go to our Na Young-kyung standing by at the news center. Hyun-kyung?
Yusun, the Ministry of Education has told the country's 17 metropolitan and provincial education offices not to take their students on a mass school trip, at least for the first half of this year. The decision was made at a meeting this Monday. Education officials also decided to temporarily postpone any training activities of students if safety measures are not properly in place. The ministry also plans to develop and distribute safety manuals to help schools safely guide their students when traveling by airplanes or water transportation.
Hyun-kyung, fresh speculations are rising as personnel from Tanwon High School claim to have received a phone call from the Jeju Coast Guard at around 8:10 a.m. of the day of the accident. Do you have any updates on that?
Yes, I do, Yusun. Earlier in the day, the Gyeonggi-do Provincial Office of Education said a Tanwon High School's teacher received a call from the Jeju Coast Guard asking for a cell phone number of a teacher in charge of the field trip that brought more than 300 Tanwon High School students on board the Seolho ferry on the accident day. But Jeju Coast Guard officials are now saying that it was a local policeman who called Tanwon High School and not one of their officials. The caller, unaware of the fact that the ferry's arrival time had been delayed, went out to the port to guide the students and apparently called the school when he didn't see any ferry coming in. The initial call time was said to be 8:10 a.m., about 40 minutes before the sunken ferry is recorded to have first contacted the Marine Traffic Service at its destination, Jeju Island. But now, reports are saying that it was about 8:20 a.m. and more investigation is definitely needed to officially confirm the facts and details.
So there's still a lot more investigating to be done regarding this case. Speaking of which, how is the investigation progressing?
Well, the joint investigation team composed of the police and the prosecution earlier in the day received arrest warrants for 4 additional crew members. This comes after 3 crew members, including the captain, were arrested on Saturday on charges including negligence of duty. Some 20 people related to the renovation have been summoned. Renovation of the ferry, the Seolho ferry, that is, have been summoned for questioning, as well as reports come in that the 20-year-old ferry might have undergone months of renovation to overly extend its sailing life for more than 7 years. Investigators are also said to have secured transcripts of SNS messages of some 400 passengers that were on board the ferry. They are currently being analyzed, and I will bring you more updates on our later newscasts. Yusun.